Welcome back. We are here with the famous Nate the bartender, otherwise known as Nate Brocious, here at Deschutes.
Indeed.
What charming qualities do you have about you that make you a great bartender?
Well, I'm a people person. I'm a man of the people. I love meeting strangers, people who come in town for the first time, who've never been to Bend, people that come from a long ways away. You know, Canada, Europe, we get a lot of travelers. So I like to be the contact person for those people. I like to be one of the first people that they meet, the first people that they see. That way I can ensure they have a great time here.
What question has stumped you?
What question has stumped me? Probably, do we have Coors Light? That's probably the question that stumps me.
Uh-huh.
That probably stumps me the most.
Yeah.
The only question.
Is it hard to not roll your eyes when someone says that?
No.
Do you have to just be really nice and just turn on the charm and say, you know what?
No, well, a lot of people, they've never been to a brewery before. Maybe they don't understand how craft beer works, and that's okay. We're open to that. We want people to come in and they may say, hey, do you have Coors Light? And we say, no, but you know what we do have is Deschutes River Ale, which is an easy drinking, lager finish. And they try that and they go, great. This is what I like drinking, but at Deschutes Brewery. And it makes them feel comfortable.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
How long have you been a bartender in your life?
18 months.
Wow.
Since he was 12.
I was a barista before that. So in a way, it's kind of the same thing.
Yeah.
I get to see the same people that I used to see in the mornings at night. So I'm getting the same clientele just at a different part of the day. You know what I mean?
I do know what you mean. And Mackenzie knows what you mean.
Yeah, I hit it both in a day.
Yeah.
Get coffee in the morning, beer at night.
You got to have your uppers and your downers. There you go.
I have a good question.
Please do.
First, do you have siblings?
I do. I have one brother.
And are you the baby of the family?
I am.
Knew it.
Yep. Yep, absolutely.
I just wanted to prove that. You can tell because he's super, super outgoing, and I could just see why he's a bartender because, I'm the baby of the family, too.
There you go. Absolutely. You know.
It answers so many questions.
for many of the viewers.
Yes. So did you apply to be a bartender, or did you start out doing something else?
Yeah, I started.
And why in the world did they pick you to be a bartender if you didn't have any experience?
Well, it started out, so I was hired when they did all the expansion. So when this building opened, they hired quite a few new people. And so I waited in line at the brewery with everyone else, 1,200 people waiting in line.
Wow, that's daunting.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Did you have to sing?
I sang to myself, but not out loud. Eye of the Tiger, of
course,
to keep my concentration.
You can sing out loud in
the
segment because she kind of teased the segment
by
singing this part.
Some people
song.
Might not call
okay.
that singing.
Do you want to reprise a little chorus? Go ahead.
We can work on a duet or
like
that.
I'll hold off for now. This is Nate's time to shine.
Okay.
Enough
so
about.
You're one of 1,200.
Yeah. So, I waited in line and I got the job. There were about, I think there were about between 30 and 40 jobs. So I got the job and I started out as a host on the door, which is fine. I love people. Again, you're that contact point for people. So it was super great. But then as I became a server, they thought, this guy seems like he'd be good behind the bar. And they were right. And there I was behind the bar.
Is that because you were dropping lots of food?
I try not to.
I know you try, but...
Every once in a while to keep myself honest.
They had to keep the product loss at a minimum.
We need write-offs. So, I got behind the bar, and I really enjoyed it, and they thought I did a good job, and so that's where I've been. So I go between bartending, and I do some serving as well, but, anything where I can talk to people and, educate people and let people have a great experience, that's something that I'm super passionate about.
Did you grow up here?
No, I grew up in Phoenix, actually, but my wife is from here, so I feel like it gives me some street cred.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, in a way, I'm a native. Right?
Yeah.
I'm a half native.
You're naturalized native.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
In your 18 months, you must have learned how to pour a beer well.
I am.
And that's not as easy as some people might think.
That's correct.
Give me one tip so the next time I go out for a bartending job.
Like you need a tip about how to pour a beer.
I do.
Uh-huh. Okay. Go ahead. We'll pretend.
Yeah, so Well, so you know when they press down the pint glass and that water shoots up into the glass?
Yeah.
What that's actually doing is a lot of the glasses get pitted on the inside. So what that water does is it coats all those little micro pits so that when you pour the beer in, it there's less foam that comes from the beer. So that's one way that makes it easier. But what I do is I pull the tap, let just a little bit drain out, put the cup underneath there and just let it fill naturally.
45 degrees?
Absolutely.
47?
45.
45, okay.
I'm a man of principle.
No cheating. And then does it depend on the beer in terms of the amount of head?
Of head. Well, ours, yeah. So ours have a little line of where the actual beer stops. Is it cheating or are we just well prepared?
I'll let you
answer the question.
Just as long as it doesn't dip below that line.
Of course. Hey, you got to get bang for your buck. People want that. And so they know where the line is, so they know where to look, which is
next
great.
Next time I go, I'm making sure that
please
that
do. Is. That's why we have it.
So before we let you go,
yeah,
what is your favorite Deschutes beer?
Red Chair.
That was the quickest answer.
Thank goodness somebody said it's this.
So, you know, Bachelor
you
Bitter
guys
is our local.
To be politically correct here. You know, you don't want to upset
look,
the ball.
I like Red Chair. And, you know, Bachelor Bitter is our local's favorite. That is the hardcore Bend beer, Bachelor Bitter. But for me, it's Red Chair. It's a catch-all. It has a wonderful hop aroma. They use some Pilsner malt, which gives it a really clean finish when you're drinking it. Some IPAs have that kind of resiny finish. But it doesn't have that. It has a little bit of malt body, so it's perfectly balanced. It unites, you know, your German styles, your, you know, hoppy people. It gets all those people together.
Did you see how quickly he went into beerology?
Yeah,
so
into his mode.
Right, I'm right there.
Wow. He was there. People have to come in and see you and get a beer.
Absolutely, they do.
Okay, you can sing Bartender. You can sing Eye of the Tiger to take us out.
Okay.
Now.
Three, two, go.
It's the eye of the tiger. It's the thrill of the fight.
I don't know the rest of the lyrics, though. You never let me sing past that part.
I didn't even get to the challenge of our rivals yet. Oh, well, okay.
Next time.
Okay, next time.
Next time.